future satisfaction. By what do we really want? What really gives us pleasure? What kind of pleasures do we want? And again, this would seem to me to be about cultural consensus, about people putting ideas out into the culture, or they might be plays or dances or all sorts of things, which give us pictures of ways of being that we might aspire to.
But you see, the idea that there are no wrong feelings is an immensely threatening idea to people who are afraid to feel in any case. And this is one of the peculiar problems of our culture, that we are terrified of our feelings because they take off on their own. And we think that if we give them any scope, and if we don't immediately beat them down, they will lead us into all kinds of chaotic, destructive action. It's so funny that we, in our Western culture today, say that kind of thing. We who do more chaotic and reckless kind of action than anybody ever did. But if, for a change, we would allow our feelings and look upon their comings and goings as something as beautiful and as natural and necessary as changes in the weather, the going of night and day, and of the four seasons, we would be at peace with ourselves. Because what is problematic for Western man is not so much his struggles with other people and their needs and their problems as his struggle with his own feelings, with what he will allow himself to feel and what he won't allow himself to feel.
He's lost himself. He's become
protestations of love and goodwill are hollow. So you see, in the most basic, simple situation, a mother has she got it by accident. What is what one feels genuinely. And this must always be admitted, always allowed. It doesn't mean to say, let me emphasize this, it doesn't mean that we always are therefore compelled to act upon the basis of what we feel. That is to say, to kill the person we hate. Hatred does not necessarily lead to violence. It is unacknowledged hatred that leads to violence. Honest hatred can be expressed in much simpler ways. But the expression, the recognition, the acceptance of what is honestly felt. Whatever exists is a manifestation of